Hello and welcome to today's episode of AHS News. I'm Sakshi.
And I'm Nate. Recently, Pride and Prejudice Day was celebrated in the library. Let's take a look as the library was brought back in time to the 19th century.
Today is Pride and Prejudice Day, and it's an event that's celebrated in England every year on the 28th of January because it's the anniversary of the publication of Pride and Prejudice, which is the best book ever. I have volunteer students that are here to help run all the stations.
So today is Pride and Prejudice Day. It's celebrated by Austin fans around the world. So we have a bunch of different stations set up around the library. We have embroidery and letter writing. The orchestra is doing a performance right now. There's all sorts of fun stuff to, you know, celebrate Jane Austen and Pride and Prejudice. Ms. Coombs is the mastermind behind all of it.
We have about 12 different classes that are coming through in four blocks.
I'm Ava.
I'm Abby.
I'm Casey.
So far, have you guys learned anything from this exhibit?
I learned how to do the embroidering, so that was pretty cool.
Yeah, that was really cool. And like writing with a glass pen.
Yeah.
Memorial Hall is here. They're helping run the photo booth. You can register for a card. And they're also brought the embroidery station. We have some historical, an exhibit of historical artifacts from Andover set in the same time period as this book. Andover Center for History and Culture is another one of our partners. And they worked with us from early in the fall to curate this exhibit and also provide documents that people can interact with.
How long did this take you to organize and set up?
Since last spring. It takes a lot to put something like this together, but it's good. It's worth it. We're just celebrating a great book.
Last weekend, Andover High hosted two important robotics competitions. Let's hear from our team about what happened.
One, go!
Andover High hosted the first Tech Challenge last Saturday and Sunday. This is a prestigious robotics competition with nearly 4,000 teams nationwide where students design, build, and program a robot to perform a certain task. Last weekend's competition was a qualifying tournament involving 38 teams from all across the state, although Andover High itself did not participate. The competitions were held in the cafeteria. Team Ingenuity from Lenox won on Saturday with 450 points, while the Brainstormers from Lexington won on Sunday with 1,142 points. Congratulations to the winners, and good luck to all the AHS robotics teams in the future.
The AHS Talent Show will be held on March 4th at 7:30 p.m. If you're interested in auditioning, stop by Ms. Berge's office in the guidance today.
On Wednesday, February 9th, it was announced by Governor Charlie Baker and Commissioner of Education Jeffrey Riley that the state will not be renewing DESE's statewide mask mandate. It is now up to local school districts if they will continue with the current mask policy. The next school committee meeting is on Thursday, February 17th, 2022. It is anticipated to be the meeting where the committee will carefully consider the district's mask policy for AHS. You can tune into the meeting on Channel 99 on Comcast or Channel 43 on Verizon. You can also stream it from www.andovertv.org.
The varsity wrestling team has officially completed their regular season matches. Good luck to Jonathan, Yondell, Alec, and Jason, who is now competing in states. We spent some time with the members of the program to reflect on the season thus far.
How's it going, guys? I'm Jamie Archambault. I'm here with fellow teammate and captain Yasser Maida.
What's up, guys?
So, first question. What was your favorite meet slash match of the season?
It's got to be home, North Andover. I feel like all the boys were hype. Walkouts were nice. We had walkouts, and we just had a good crowd.
Alrighty. What do you think the future of AHS wrestling will look like?
So, as you guys know, we got eighth graders. They've been cooking in the lab at the U.
Shout out Yondell.
Shout out Yondell. Shout out Anthony Archambault.
And Jason Ballou.
They're going to go hard in the next 5 years. They're going to be monsters.
Go,
fellow teammate and captain Jonathan Davila. And the question is, how are you feeling going into the postseason?
Feeling good. Team ended the regular season 17-3, and team's looking good going into postseason. Got a lot of kids that should move on to states, and I got a big match ahead of me. Been working hard, and hopefully come out with a win.
Last question: what was your favorite match of the season?
I think it got to be when I beat the number two kid in the state. It was very intense. And
thank you.
Congratulations to the Andover High boys basketball team on a great win at the TD Garden. We also want to give a shout out to Coach Fazio, who recently got his 500th win.
Okay, so today I'm here with FaZe and player Rohit from the Andover Warriors boys basketball team, and we have a few questions for you guys today. So first, how did it feel to have the opportunity to play in the Garden?
I mean, that was sick. It was cool to get the whole jungle there. It was a really cool experience, and I hope to be there again.
And for you, FaZe, was there anything you told your team before this game to prepare them for the Garden game?
Yes. Play for each other. Have fun. But make sure you defend and rebound. And that's what it's all about.
And did it feel different playing in the Garden versus Andover High School?
Big time. I mean, bigger court. It's kind of weird playing there. It's like, oh, we had fun.
First of all, there's nothing like the Dunn Gym with the jungle. So I'd rather play in the Dunn Gym any day over the Garden. Our players might disagree, but when we have the Dunn Gym rocking and our student body's there and the jungle's there, there's no better feeling than that.
Thank you, guys.
Let's take a look at the innovations that our Andover High School students tried selling to a group of revered entrepreneurs.
Our first entrepreneur is revolutionizing your drive to work.
Okay, hello, Sharks. I'm Ryan G. Mossy, and I'm here for Traffic Awayinator. So my pitch to you guys is,
I think your product is really good. Obviously, uranium is really cheap these days. We could just get it, so that seems like a pretty worthwhile investment.
So, like, are there multiple dimensions this can teleport to? And if so, can you choose?
Pre-programmed in the other dimensions. So we had to go to each one of those dimensions and put up a cell tower there.
How did you figure all this out?
At work at Andover High School.
I see. Yeah, we do have.
That's a really good pitch. I think that this product could really, you know, selling it for
less than it costs to buy one.
See that?
And you're trying to own 30% of the company here.
That's going to be welcome to the future. In fact, you were dieting specifically to get away from hamburgers. So what do? You get the food brick. Look how happy you are now.
What about fiber? There's no fiber.
Yeah, there is fiber in there. That's what I was forgetting.
Are you sure?
There is fiber. I was forgetting your box saturated as the gamers in the audience will surely identify the person that they pick off the street. On average, the amount that a normal person eats is what is defined as the recommended amount customarily consumed, or RACC. And that is how we determine serving sizes.
I'm going to offer you to get off my stage.
Yeah.
That's it for this episode.
Tune in next H1 for a new episode of the AHS News.